psychopaths or criminal offenders, they lack conscience, they lack remorse, they lack guilt. A part of the brain that's critically involved in emotion, the amygdala, is a brain area we scanned in a group of psychopaths and compared the volume, the size of the amygdala in the psychopaths compared to the normal control group. And what we documented here is that the amygdala, which is critically important for emotions, is reduced in volume by 18% in the psychopaths compared to the normal controls. So if you have a psychopathic criminal offender in front of you who doesn't care about what they have done, that isn't concerned about the victims and does not seem remorseful, you can ask yourself, what makes a person like that? And I think part of the answer is that they have a structural impairment to that emotional part of the brain, the amygdala, that gives rise to these feelings of empathy and warmth and care and love for other people. We were interested in the amygdala. We were interested in the fact that psychopaths make bad moral decisions. Now we know that when we make moral decisions, that brain area, the amygdala, is quite strongly activated. You might be familiar with some of the laboratory tasks that we use to give people difficult moral decisions. You know, one is the trolley dilemma. Mm-hmm. You've got a runaway train on a railway track going to kill 5 railway workers. You are standing on a footbridge looking over the railway line. Standing next to you is a large gentleman. You can save the 5 lives if you push the big man off the bridge. He stops the train, he dies, but you save 5. Question, will you push him off the bridge? You won't, but some people would. You really should. It's utilitarian moral decision making. 5 for 1. I think no matter what we decide, we get a little bit emotional. And the reason for that is that the amygdala is activated. What we found when we put psychopaths through a test like that and assess amygdala function, we find that the higher the psychopathy score, the lower the amygdala function. Emotion drives moral behavior, the feeling of what is right and wrong. That feeling is very important in whether we do right from wrong. But if the amygdala is burnt out in psychopaths for reasons beyond their control, then how moral is it of us to punish psychopaths as harshly as we do? Has the criminal justice system got it right when it comes to punishment and responsibility? Although, of course, this is a very difficult question to answer, and it goes beyond science, certainly.